is just an amazing turnout. We're so happy that you are here to share this moment with us, with your child. A little background first is always good, so you know what's been happening in theater. I know that you read the newsletters, but I just want to go over a couple of points. Since they start here in school, they learn skills in every subject, basic skills that we build upon and continue through, and that helps us to get to the next level and so forth. So the skills previously learned in theater are learning how to work with the space that we're in, the dynamics of moving, tempo, which is timing, levels to have variations, which you can see we have, so children sitting, standing, those are different levels. They know how to project their voice so it carries. Hopefully everybody knows, remembers what to do. That's just a reminder, please make sure you can film, but make sure your cell phones have no sound on them. Thank you. It's just distracting. So they've learned about stage directions. They've learned about directing because they even have the opportunities to sit in small groups and become the director. What would you do to fix this, change this? What do you see? A compliment, a suggestion. There's lots of tools that go into this. Last year, if your child was here and came to see our storytelling show, this is a continuation of storytelling. It's narration through performance. It's a continuation of making an adaptation to something that we've already seen or heard, performed, or read. This is an adaptation on a fairy tale. It just so happens that I wrote fairy tale, this adaptation, so the one thing that they got to do, because I am niece, the playwright, I gave them permission to make an adaptation upon my adaptation. So they got to learn a little bit about playwriting, the fact that we can't necessarily change another person's work unless they're given permission. So they learned a lot of the little nuances that come with this. They also have vocabulary that they're learning. One of the big things in this is pantomime and tableau. They are in tableau now. Tableau is like taking a picture, still shot, where they're frozen in time and space. Pantomime, you know what mimes do. Pantomime is what they'll be doing, where they'll be moving. It'll look like they're speaking, but their voices have to be off because we have to hear certain characters speak. There's a larger script here this year than there was last year. There's more props, there's more cues, there's more movement. Third grade is a very pivotal point for your students in learning and in theater because everything that they've learned to this point, this is it for production. Next year they get to audition for the musical. This year's musical, Finding Nemo Kids, goes up May 30th and 31st. Keep an eye out for that. And next year in fourth and then in fifth grade, we focus something a little bit, we're more focused. We're doing more history of theater and we're focusing in on ancient Greek theater and different things. So this is the last big performance of this type. So it is a big performance. So I know you're all excited, so am I. So nervous, they're your babies, but they're my babies too, so I'm really nervous and I'm ready to go up. So here we go, welcome to Albert Outlet Mall and Snow White at the Mall.
Once upon a time, there was a girl named Snow White. She just moved into an apartment in Brooklyn. She needed to buy a bed and mattress, so she got on the bus and went to the mall. There were many stores at the mall, and each one was having a sale. Snow White walked and walked looking at so many things. She realized that she was hungry, so she stopped at the food court for a snack.
Tired after eating this apple, I'll be back.
It was closing time, and the salespeople were not sure what to do. They decided to close up and leave no one open for the night. The next morning, the store gets open, and the salespeople find Nora still asleep.